The topic is finding areas using antiderivatives. So let's look at the definition. If f of x is strictly positive on AB, then the area bounded by the x-axis and the curve y equal f of x, in this case, this part, this area is equal integral from A to B, right? Is A equal, so it's this, integral of AB of f of x dx. So let's do this problem. Calculate the area bounded by the x-axis and the parabola y equal negative x squared minus x plus 6. So first let's graph it. What's the easiest way to graph a parabola? You can use your calculator. If not, the vertex will be x equal minus b over 2a, which is minus negative 1 over 2a, which is negative 1/2. And if you plug that into the y function, so do it here, if you plug it, well, you know how to plug it in, you're supposed to get 25 over 4. So negative 1/2 is right here, and then 25 over 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, somewhere here. So here's the vertex. So let's do the horizontal tangent line. The x-intercept, how do we find x-intercept? We set minus x squared minus x plus 6 equal to 0, which means x squared plus x minus 6, which is 0. So plus 3 minus 2, x plus 3 minus 2 is 0. So x is equal negative 3, or x is equal 2. So it goes from here, 1, 2, negative 3. So this is how, and of course we know it's facing down because it's negative plus x-intercept is right here. And we're only interested in this area, right? So this is negative 3, and we said this is 2. So let's use the definition. It's pretty simple. So the area is equal integral. The limits of integration, x goes from negative 3 to 2. By the way, the function is positive. When it's positive, the integral and the area are exactly the same thing. We'll do one when the function is negative. So negative 3 to x of the function is minus x squared minus x plus 6 dx. And then now we only need to use the antiderivative. So that would be minus x cubed over 3 minus x squared over 2 plus 6x. And that's between negative 3 and 2. Now all we need to do is plug in the 2 first to give us minus 2 cubed over 3 minus 2 squared over 2 plus 6 times 2, and then minus, and then plug in negative 3 would be minus negative 3 cubed over 3 minus negative 3 squared over 2 plus 6 times negative 3. And here just use your calculator. If you use your calculator, you're supposed to get 125 over 6. So that's the area. So next example, we'll do a function that's negative, and I'll show you what we need to do. So that's it for this example.